Undead Skid Tone from Chimera. I don't know if you can actually buy this one yet. This was from their last Kickstarter. It's just a nice, like, purplish color. I'll try and find a spot that I can actually, because this isn't glued in or anything, so it kind of swivels a little annoying. That's, I mean, it's my fault, really. I guess I don't mind hitting these like strands of hair that are crossing her face right now. I can come back later and repaint those. And that's all of the flesh on this model. Because everything else is like the robot cyborg type texture. So our main light is kind of like from there. I have a light reference that I'll be using, and I'll show you a quick one now. So like all of this will be in shadow. You get a little bit of light on these cheeks. All of the light will be right here on this side. What we'll be using, mix up some skin tones from here. Checking my reference here. This can probably be darker as well. And of course, we'll get some shadows from these little hair strands. I'm And we'll get shadow from the nose and then a little more like highlight around there. So these will end up being soft shadows going into an actual highlight. Like this could actually be darker. Alright, so now we can start kind of. Actually, before I do this step, phone's over here. There's not a whole lot of chin here because that's actually that, like, this, I don't know, the other part of the robot, like, material. We'll have to reinforce these shadows a little later from the I was thinking of maybe putting like makeup on the eyelids, but now I'm going against that, so just cover them. I think maybe I should like glue this thing, this rod. Stop spinning around a little bit. So you know, right now I'm not really doing blending right now. We're just kind of sketching in where our light and shadows are going, but we're not doing like a grisaille sketch with white and black and gray. We're just kind of doing like our skin tone, so we can come back in and but easier blending. Alright, so there's meant to be a harsh shadow right there from the hair. That nose shadow needs to be pushed over a little bit more. So one of the things that differentiates like female faces from male faces is the male faces tend to have a lot harsher features. And the women's faces are like very soft features, which makes the blending a little more difficult for miniature painting. At least what I find. I'm sure there's other people that it's not as difficult. But, I'm just once again I'm checking my light references. Okay, so this should actually kind of come down the whole way. And then okay, so that's the chin. Leave a little shadow from that strand of hair. think we got our light references kind of down. Hey, what's going on, Dave? How was the trip home? Long. Did you guys go straight there? Or did you stop like halfway? One shot. Yeah, that sounds pretty damn long. But hey, you're back now, so that's good. Get to sleep in your own bed again. Now I can kind of start blending our skin tones together. They had a workshop with Banshee on Monday. It was pretty good. I learned quite a bit. He was basically teaching us how to like take our finished models to the next step and like refine our work. And it's cool, it's just showing like simple little things that like were missed, and just fixing those like really helped elevate the pieces. I need to finish 5 pieces by year end. Is that like a hard deadline for commissions or something, or is that just a personal goal? Or both. Could be both. That was pretty good. I enjoyed it. I wish I could have stayed longer, but I had work. Moses Yao was in the class too, and we got to see his work in person, and damn it, that was so good. One for Monty and 3 for people to have time to paint by Adepticon. All right. So you're going to be dominating the open category next year, huh? Only two for GED, one is for P3. Oh, that's cool. I didn't know P3 allowed custom sculpts. Then again, I don't know very much about their competition. You can make good progress on yours during the depth account in Africa's class. Oh, nice. How was your classes? How'd they go? Good. Did Tjorborn, was he able to get like a new tablet or something? Something that he could teach on? Loaned in my best one. I took three. Well, good thing you were very prepared. Also happen to have the power shift that Big Child needed. Man, you brought everything, didn't you? Didn't you bring their TV as well? I think someone needs to put you on a payroll. The one thing I don't like about this sculpt is that like sculpted on eyelashes. Kind of gets in the way. Please no. You don't want to be paid for all this work you're doing? Like, as a sculpt, I understand it, and it looks fine, but when you try to paint around it, it just gets a little messy. Alright, if you just want to, like, freely volunteer your time. The whole song. Ah. Stupid shit. Okay. So what's the next show for you? Is it MFCA? MFCA, yeah. That's May, right? Yeah, I'm glad you got another demon. He works so hard for those. So I think my next show isn't till October. We got Dragonfall in the beginning of October, and then MMSI at the end of October. So I got plenty of time to do some painting. That shadow needs a little more red tones to it. SMC, no. I don't have the money right now to fly back to Europe. Hey, what's up, Dylan? I'm over the Netherlands, I can make you dinner. I was just there. In July. I mean, I would love to go back. I'd love to do an SMC 1 year. It's just not in the cards this year. I feel like one thing I should show my kind of color scheme for this. True, I didn't know you back then, so I missed you. That's true. There was also so many people at World Model Expo that even if we did know each other, it probably would have been easy to miss. Go to SMC this year and bring something? Yeah, you're gonna bring your sister of battle. Where'd it go? I mean, the Sister of Battle can probably go into open since you sculpted the head, so that is like a conversion. And one thing I learned in Banshee's class on Monday that I really need to implement is thinning paint with inks. That way the pigments don't like separate and like the paint still stays pretty creamy. So I gotta get myself some more inks. Not sure I'll have anything ready by then, but sure going to try. What I know it's in October, but like when in October is SMC? Or mainly focus on GD 2024. Let's say this one was super tough. There's a lot of amazing entries, and apparently they gave out less finalist pins than normal. So I guess in the past, if you made first cut, you got a finalist pin, but this year you needed to make like second cut to get a finalist pin. Like the competitive spirit of GD over World Model Expo. See, I'm the opposite way. I mean, I don't mind the competitiveness. I was a athlete for many years, so I get it. But I don't know. I kind of like the art showcase of like an open competition. Mid to late October, I think. So it's probably going to be like the same weekend as MMSI. Yeah, not that I can really afford to go back to Europe just yet, so. Yeah. Darker. I like both, but for me, this moment I tried something telling me I suck and I should do better, and GD is better for that, I feel. Well, they'll definitely tell you that you suck and should do better. That's really one thing GD is good for. GD is a bit more clean cut in that way and how it's laid out and the people that attend. Nice excuse to have a small holiday.
Yeah.
Was it that rough this year? It was pretty rough. There was a lot of amazing stuff though. So like the standard was higher, but yeah. They made a few decisions that not everyone agreed with. I mean, one thing they seem to do is they kind of reinforce the fact that if you have an out there style like Kaha, no matter how beautifully painted it is, they're not really gonna award you, which really sucks. Because her stuff is absolutely incredible. I think one of the things, like, not rewarding Kaha, it kind of stifles creativity from everybody else. Because it shows that they're not looking for really creative pieces. They're looking for something that fits into their mold. Kaha doesn't paint clean most of the time, and GW is kind of painting clean though. Yes, that's the thing. Like, Sergio Calvo doesn't paint clean all the time either, and he got two golds. I did chat with her at WME last year and see her work in real life. She kind of liked it that different competitions have different ways of appearing. Well, I mean, okay. I feel like if she likes that, then she should know that she could change her style for GED if she wants to win. Like, I don't know. She's an incredible painter. I love looking at her work. Anytime I get to see her work in person, it's amazing. She came the last 2 years. I was at WME. She was there. It was great seeing it. I hope she keeps coming over. Honestly, I hope she doesn't change. Because her work is absolutely fantastic. What up, Rich? How you doing today? Just wants to show off her work and make people happy and meet up. She doesn't come to the events just to win. I mean, if that's her goal, she definitely succeeds because everyone talks about her stuff like the entire time. So. Or that sunny skin tone or peachy skin tone. They call it shiny skin tone. That's what Mark Masclans calls this. Gonna make that shadow just a little bit softer, but still pretty apparent. Kind of highlight that little line in here. I'll come back and put a black line on there. It's still. It's still flesh, but it has that line. Yeah, we were talking about Kaha. Paint because you like that way instead of painting the wind is a good one. Yeah, well, I agree. It. Gotta stop mixing with this tiny brush. Not a fan of GD, to be honest. Yeah. I mean, there's so many competitions I like better, but I still want to win one for some reason. Honestly, to me, getting like a bronze at Monty would be more of an achievement than winning a gold in Golden Demon. artsy way of things as well. It would be way better for my work if they would change that up. Let's get this color. Gonna put a little color in the hairs just so we can see the hair like reacts to the color in the face. On, get out. Get out. There we go. Make one amazing piece and win both. I wish. Right now, my focus is on Dragonfall. It's the next show. It's an open show, so it's better in my eyes. Anyone honestly what they're looking for, I don't think it would really work in other comps. I mean, unless you count the open. Like Sergio won gold in open, and I think that would do well at Monty. Hoping to come up with Dragonfall in my first year. Dragonfall is a local like gaming convention with a painting competition. It used to be in Illinois, now it's in Wisconsin. I put that right in the white. I'm an idiot. A few strands of hair there. I'm gonna get a bigger brush to do more hair at the same time. What are we calling winning? I just meant like winning a demon and getting a medal in Masters at Monty. Not necessarily winning best in show at both or something with the same piece. I don't think that'll ever happen. Bronze in any category. Yeah, as long as it's, in Masters. Like, I feel like it's probably been done before already. Like, Andy has to have brought some of his demon stuff and. Even if Open still awards plaques this year, they gave out demons, which I'm not sure was intended. Yeah, that seemed pretty strange, especially considering they said they had a box of demons like break on them and they were running low. I wonder if that box also contained the Open plaques and those were busted. Hi, 10X. How's it going? PW always has demons for open. You just can't get to. No, they used to have. Up until this year, they awarded, like, plaques. You know, like a piece of wood with a. What was that? Like the original Citadel Miniatures logo? Hot glued on. And you can see, like, hot glue coming through the openings. It was. Pretty low quality. It was funny. I was wondering if Golden Demon Compendium had a I know they have statistic breakdown of like country like swords by country. And I was just wondering, like, if there was a breakdown of, like, Slayer Swords won by category. So I started just looking into it myself. And I saw, like, in the mid-90s. I think it was. Like, 93, 94, something like that. Someone won the sword from the open category. Oh, there's an ear here. I guess that should be flesh as well. And this model has a lot of hair. How did Adepticon go? Adepticon was great. Hung out with a lot of people, met a lot of people for the first time. Bought too much stuff. I won a sword winner from the Youngblood category one year. Albert Moretto Font almost did that. I mean, I think his first year he won gold in Youngblood and everyone was like blown away by his model, and it was his second year he was no longer eligible for Youngblood and he won Slayer Sword. Used to have a separate sword for employees, so I think people could win from open when they had that sword too. Well, that was the only sword listed as one that year. I do know they did have like an employee sword for a little bit. And they did have like a best in Forge World as well. I don't know, maybe they awarded. I just put my hand right in paint. Maybe they awarded the sword to open and people complained, so then they made that rule. I mean, I didn't recognize the name, so I don't know if he was an employee of GW or not. I'm not one of those GW nerds that knows like every single employee ever and the entire history of the company and the Golden Demons. Sorry if I offend any UK viewers, because that seems to be the people that are obsessed with that knowledge. The only employee winner I know is Tim L Listen. Well, it depends on if we want to start drama or not. Call Gavin an employee. Even though he wasn't actually an employee yet. All right, are we almost done with this frickin' hair? He's the store manager in Orland Park, I think it's 4 or 5. I don't think store managers count though for like, I think it's just like the heavy metal team. But if he's the manager at Orland Park, I probably met him and just didn't know who he was at the time. I mean, I only went to the Orland Park store once early in my painting career. A little more red over there. Super nice and chill at the show on Sunday. Him and John are friends. All right. You know, I had no idea that Bob was like getting coached by Todd Swanson. And he introduced me to him on a Saturday, and he's like, "Yeah, this is Todd." I'm like, "Oh, hey, how's it going?" And then the next day, it's like, "Oh, Todd Swanson? You mean the guy who's won like 4 Slayer Swords?" I had no idea what he looked like. I had that all the time last year. I got no clue how anyone looks like. Yeah, I mean, unless they make videos and show their face in the video, I probably don't know what they look like. Like, if I met Richard Gray, I mean, maybe if I heard his voice, because I hear his voice on his videos all the time, but all I know is what his hands look like. But there's a lot of like high quality painters for Golden Demon that don't really have like an online presence. They're kind of just like they do their day job and then they go home and then they paint by themselves. Don't post pictures online. Show up to the competition and win awards. Don't let GW know you recognize people by their hands. Why, what's a... Is that wrong? Aren't they doing hands only now or something? Oh, and they're like painting videos? I recognize the hands. That would be kind of scary. I guess. I mean, that's all I'm showing right now. Eventually, I'll get a face cam when I can buy another camera, but... Yeah, I think they like stopped... having like the presenters like fully on screen or something and showing too much personality, because then the presenters became the star of the show and not the miniatures, and then they left the company and made their own YouTube channels and became more popular than the Warhammer painting videos. I guess that's what's happened with like Duncan and Peachy and like someone else. Not gonna pretend like I ever actually watched those Warhammer videos, but this is what I have heard. I didn't even know who Peachy was, to be honest, till the drama started after he left. Yeah. Well, I think Duncan and Peachy used to do like videos together, and then Duncan left, and then it was just Peachy, and then honestly, I couldn't tell you what Peachy looked like. I know what Duncan looks like because his face gets posted all over Reddit as like, the painting messiah. So Rich, how's your thinker bus coming along? Alfonso showed off a preview of his next bust in that series, and it looks really, really cool. It's a like a you know. A 1920s or like early 1900s like boxer in that like classic old school boxing pose. You can have a gloved hand or non-gloved hand. And the coolest thing is like he fought with scale 75 for this, but it's only gonna cost $25. So it will not be an expensive bust. Haven't worked on it much. I got the kids in there. Oh no. It's not COVID, is it? Or is it just regular con crud? I saw a lot of people saying that they tested positive. I tested myself yesterday and so now I'm negative. I'll test again in a few days because it's supposed to be 5 days from exposure, and yesterday was 5 days from my first day there. So I will test again in a day or two. Right now, I'm not feeling any different. That shadow is still kind of harsh. Oof. Sorry to hear that. Fall over. You work from home, right? So can you still like get time off for having COVID, or would they say fuck off? You work from home. Keep working. Today's your last day of PTO. Oh. Sorry about that. Oh no, that's skin. Okay, well, I got a bit of blue on that. I gotta fix that. All right, so the bit of like android skin around the face is going to be white. In fact, the main body is going to be white. Where is the, oh, there's the line. Okay. I'm doing the cold white that I do with the cold flesh and then build up. We'll probably get this side even darker though. I'm just putting a base coat down. One thing I took away from this weekend and the Alfonso class was I need to go heavier on my contrast. Like, I try to be too subtle with things. And it doesn't really work out on miniatures. Time to sleep. This lady's gonna look beautiful. Looking forward to see her next time again. Have a wonderful stream. Hey, thanks for stopping by. Have a good night's sleep. Catch you next time. I see they're chill about it. They would let me take time if I needed it. Well, that's cool. Or you could just be like that other guy that you work with and just not show up and don't tell anybody. Okay, so has he gotten in trouble for that? Or do they just like let it slide? Okay, that should be blue. Okay. That's YouTube listening. They're making an HR thing about it. Well, that's good, I guess. So all of this should be white. Yes. I guess on another client, he missed a call. The client just never showed up at all. Man. Does he know, like, is he, like, family friends with a boss or something? Like, how did that not get him fired? I don't remember what panels are what is kind of I should really check that out before doing this. This is going to be blue. I guess this would be white as well. And we'll make this panel white. Don't have to be alternating or anything. We can make these bits white, like her arm is going to be fully white, but her shoulders can be gold. These extra plates here, they can be gold. Doesn't sound like he knows anybody. Then how is this guy still employed? Does he have narcolepsy or something? Is that like getting by the ADA? I still need to work on the face a lot. Like they're frustrated with him though, and they'll probably give him a warning or something if he needs to let him go, yeah. Get this a little darker. Try to get this shadow piece here. So let me check my light reference. How much of this chin? Kind of dark. Gonna try to do some Eric Swinson cast shadows on this piece. She's got the samurai sword like right in front of her. There. Extend this shadow from the nose. More of that color in there. Need it to be all like grayish black. I feel like that was weird. I did, yes. I got it yesterday. I feel like the last one that I ordered directly from them came pretty quick too, once I got the shipping notification. On the phone reading CC. Hopefully it's not saying something really stupid. Sometimes the CC mixes things up. Okay. I think the shadow from the nose is okay. I think it's just the highlight is a little too much. Let's tone down that highlight. Yeah, did you say you got the Danko too, the first turtle? Much. Still too bright. Both turtles in the pirate bus. Nice. That Danko was a lot of fun to paint. We can round that a little more. Did you get any of the little found pieces, like the Pinocchio or the Hansel and Gretel? They aren't out yet. I thought the Pinocchio like went up for order. I really like the look of the Hansel and Gretel one, but man, I have so much stuff right here to paint, and I just bought a bunch more at Adepticon. I feel like I need to get one of those counters that Matt Yee has right now. Try to keep track of days without buying a new miniature. So last night I already bought I bought another STL from Festarium. Planning for Resin Beast already. Honestly, Resin Beast was pretty good. I wish I had taken my miniatures a little more seriously. Okay, the Hansel this time. Yeah, that one looks pretty cool. If I end up not pulling the trigger, I can just hope that Sabot Miniatures buys a few to sell on their site. Or that dude at MMSI buys a bunch and has them for sale. Get white blue. I just always like passed by all the people in the hallway without paying any attention to them. But that's gonna be the first shop I hit up at this next show. All right, catch you later, Rich. Hope you feel better. Hope this doesn't last too long for you. Try to use some pure white here, see what happens. Then I'm going to have to come back and black line around this little separation there. Let me find my tiniest brush. I need to get some more of these. I was not expecting to use a 3-0 brush as much as I did, but really came in clutch for those Golden Demon entries. Stuff like this. Black lining little things here. But this one is like dying. It was a bit of a mistake, but thankfully it's in the shadow side, so it's pretty easy to correct. I don't know if I should. I'll keep that in there. Of highlighting the weird, like, skin panel here. Not hard to. One more right under this panel here. We need to kind of blend that in a little better here. So she's got sculpted eyebrows, so we gotta hit those with that blue. I just realized the time. This will be one of the last things to do today. As long as there's a little bit of color, that's fine. These strands are casting shadows. They should be fairly bright. I was hoping to find a really nice, like, electric blue from someone. I didn't really find one. The best I got was this Andrea blue from Vallejo. I guess what I should really look for is a fluorescent blue. Get a little more white on that. Loving this so far, but I really need to be going. Too much to do before I have to leave again. Yeah, man, get your rest in, get your packing done. I'm actually going to be ending pretty soon, too. In about like 10 more minutes or so. But it was good to finally meet you in person. Sure, we will be at many more conventions and competitions together. Next year I'm playing, right? That's the plan. Like, I'm gonna try and get a hotel room, if not at the actual hotel, one that's like super nearby, like easy walking distance. Way I can stick around like all Saturday night. We can keep that tournament going all night if we need to.